Hey friends, so I wanted to show you. I did the gauge swatch for that mosaic blanket that's going to be starting February 9th. And I know it's bigger than hers because I'm using a 4-ply worsted. She's using a 3-ply. 3 is smaller. She's using a F hook for her gauge, or a G hook is what she calls for. And I did the recommended H, which is 1 up. I tried it with a G and it curled it too tightly. So anyways, hers would be, she said 11 centimeters by 11 centimeters. I think hers is that 4? 4 by 4? Mine is 6 by 6. But I wanted mine a little bit bigger anyways, because her finished size would have only been, oh, I think it was like maybe 4 foot by 4 foot, something like that. So I wanted mine a little bit longer and bigger. So, but anyways, I made a chocolate Easter egg. My colors are in retro. I will pop a picture up in here to show you my colors. There was 4 colors. The cream is the main. This is the walnut color that she called for, which to me is like a dark brown. And then there is a spice color, like, and mine's more like a burnt orange, and then a mustard color. So, but anyways, I made myself this. This is what she suggested to do for the gauge swatch, is to make a mug rug. So that's what I did, and mine again is 6 by 6. So now I'm in my sewing room, and I am going to paper piece that second heart trivet, and see if I can get that one done today. But anyways, I'm going to let you go. I just wanted to show you. Oh, and it's a beautiful sunny day today. Beautiful sunshine. Woke up to frost on everything. Blue skies. February 4th. Today's our oldest son's birthday. He is 42 years old. So, but it was 22 degrees this morning. Supposed to get up to 46 today. We'll see. Because it was 37, but if it does, it does. But anyways, I'm gonna let you go. I'm gonna get back to sewing. Talk to you later. Okay, so I'm sitting here getting ready to paper piece some more. I got the hearts laid out so I know what direction they go. This is what they look like before trimming, and then this is after sewing on the line. So this is what I was saying the other day. This is the side that you sew on, the dark lines on the inside. So you're putting, number 1 is the main fabric right here, and then number 2, which is a fabric, is this little itty bitty. And what I'll do is I flip it over and I make sure that I have the right side facing the right side. And all you're going to do is you're just going to line it up. And as long as it goes over that quarter inch right there, you should be good. And then you just hang on to it, flip it over. And then you line it up like that. And let me see if I can sew this. So I sewed right on that line. My stitch length is right here. It has to be pretty tiny so you can break, rip the paper apart. So it's like that. And then you're just going to push it back like that and press it. And then once I do that, I'll take the next piece, flip it over, and it's number 4 and B. And all these are background, so they're all the same color. And I'll do the same thing. I'll line it up here, sew it, flip it over, and then you'll get this. So that's how you do paper piecing, the fast version.